Hi, I'm Debbie, and welcome to Divine Destiny with Debbie. Today we're reading for July 16th, 17th, and 18th, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Now, this is a general reading, and of course I'm using my Radley Valentine decks. I'm using my Angel Tarot cards for the main message. I will pull one from my Archangel Power Tarot cards. I'll also pull one from my Emily Anderson Crystal deck. Now, I have prayed, meditated, and infused all the decks with Reiki energy. But remember, this is a general reading. It may or may not resonate. Take what you like. Leave the rest. I am an intuitive channeler. I open myself to higher power, and my job is just to deliver the message. And try not to have to, you know, put too much of my understanding into this. Anyway, I want to let you know this is kind of that housekeeping session. So things to know. I have done the long readings. They are posted for Leo season. And the first 30 minutes is the overview and what is going on planetary-wise in Leo season. I do put the time marker in so you can, if you cross-watch, so if you do your ascending, rising, moon, Venus, if you cross-watch, you can just go right to the reading. Okay, so let's put that out there. I do have a poll out right now, and what I am asking, I've been doing this for, I think a couple of weeks. I have been using my Waite Rider deck. I've been doing this mostly in the introduction. So, and it is how I'm, you know, how I feel that I'm kind of called to do it or not do it. So I'm asking about this. I have been using my Guardian Angel deck. This is Radley Valentine. And so the poll basically is, choose one. Do you like, you know, what do you like the most? Do you like the Waite Rider deck in the introduction when I use it? Do you like having a Guardian Angel card towards the, you know, when I'm doing the main reading? That's when I'm usually using them. Do you like both just basically when I feel called to do it? Or stop, I don't want you to do any of that. So kind of, you know, let me know. We're just going to keep this going for a while. I really am interested in what you have to say about this. I do have other things going on in just in general life. I'm actually opening up a Reiki practice. So that in itself, I really do enjoy that. And I do find that actually helps. It helps many, many people. So I'm starting that. I'm also working on my website a little more. And so you might have seen, you know, so yeah. Bear with me on that one, okay? I am on Facebook. I do have an Instagram account. I don't really use that as much. I'm doing more with Facebook, or I'm trying to do more with the community page on YouTube, because I know that there's many people that don't like to go to the other social media sites. So I'm trying to, what I can put on YouTube, I try to put on. Okay? Okay. So I think that kind of does an overview. So remember, reversed cards have a stronger meaning to me. And if they fly out, it definitely is a strong meaning. Also, too, remember the button. Like, share, subscribe, click on the bell. I've had people tell me that, Deb, I do all of that, and then you disappear. So not quite sure what's happening with that. So please go on, look at the long readings. Please go on, do the poll. Read whatever I'm posting from my website, and why don't we just start the readings? Okay. Hello, my Aries. How are you? Well, let's see what we have going on for the weekend. I hope you do look at the long readings for Aries. It was interesting. I think you had a really good one, too. Yeah, I do think so. Here we go. Let's go on and see how the weekend energies will be for you. 1, 2, and 3. Nothing is reversed, but that's okay. Okay. First card for my Aries. 3 of Air. Now, Leo got the same thing. Leo got this 3 of Air. So there is a lot of energy that needs to be released and let go of. There is a lot of old stuff hanging over you. Now, you're a little bit different than Leo message for this, but there is this kind of this sense of, that itch in the back that you just can't quite reach, or you can't just quite, you can't scratch it to really make it go away. This needs to go away. This needs to move. Now, threes have a lot of energy for, there's a lot of power. There's the power of three. There is, you know, when you do something three times and you, you know, you say something three times, or when you get two other people to be in agreement with you, there's that type of power. Also the Trinity power. Also the, you know, there's a lot of creativity with this energy. But the air energy is our Libra, our Aquarius, and also our Gemini thought processes. It's air. It's not necessarily something you can necessarily capture, you know, but yet it's all around us. It's needed. So it's our thought processes. It's our plans. It also could be hearing news. Now, the Three of Air has a sense of sadness to it. The Three of Air has a sense of settling with this. The Three of Air has a little bit of a, oh, this is just the way it is. Nothing's going to change. You know, what am I going to do? What am I going to do? You know, but the thing is, when you look at the traditional tarot cards, it's that heart with those three swords in it. You have to realize that it's something that you're holding with. Okay, the three, okay, if these were new, if this was new sadness, if this was something to really kind of, you know, kind of like take everything, kind of like, oh my gosh, there's major change. There's, oh my gosh, it's too much for me. This heart would not look how it's looking. Think about it. It's got three swords in it. Now, at the same time, these will be something that you carry with you, but it is something that is old. So you need to just kind of incorporate it a little bit. You need to kind of think about some of these past hurts, and you need to kind of say, okay, even though some part of me is not necessarily as happy as I'd like it to be, I can still choose to move forward with this. You know, these are events that happened. Something happened in that past, and it could be an immediate past. It could be a childhood trauma. And I feel like there could be some childhood trauma that might be rearing its head back up again. But it's still something that you can, you know, think through, work through. And, you know, again, too, leave it, give it to your angels, give it to God, give it to higher power, give it to the source, divine, whoever that is for you. And just say, you know what, this is too much for me to handle, too much for me to carry. I don't want it anymore. I don't want it anymore. I learned from my experiences. Don't get me wrong with that, Aries. Learn from your experiences. It's not that you're ignoring it or saying it never happened. It's just, I don't want this energy to affect me and keep me from my blessings. Okay? Wow, you had a lot more. You had a lot more about this one. But great sadness, take time to heal. The need to forgive yourself or others. And again, it's like, sometimes carrying this weight is just too much energy. It's too much energy. Let it go. Guilt, in many ways, if you can't, you know, if you've tried to resolve it, if you've tried to make some positive changes, guilt then becomes a useless emotion. And if somebody's guilting you and you've tried to do your best to resolve it, it's time to move on. Okay, next card, the Six of Fire. Here's your moving on. Here you are, moving on. Now, and this is interesting. We might have something going with the numbers, 3 and a 6. You know, 6 is 2 times 6. 3 plus 3. 6 is the number of man. It's what you make of it. It's your energies that you've put in. Fire is your energy. It's also Leo, and we're about to go into Leo season. It's also Sagittarius, passionate, burning, determined. This is a victorious solution. This is riding into victory. So whatever this is, whatever this past sadness is, this is saying, you know, let this go. This is transitioning into this, okay? Bring back your optimism. Bring back that hope. Be the person that you are meant to be. Now, many times over, you know, this is, I feel like, you know, it's like, okay, I need to tell you this. Many times over, the darker energies, the ones that aren't trying to work well with us, they try to keep us in here because we're meant to go here, okay? So there's some real contemplation this weekend for you. There's some prayer time for you. There's some meditation time for you. But it's time to live. It's time to live. Victory. Good news is on its way. public recognition or awards. People could be, noticing you more and more also. So let's kind of let this go. People could be noticing you more and more. And, it's okay. Don't feel guilty. Don't feel you don't, I don't deserve it. No. Ride into it. Next card. The Seven of Water. The Seven of Water. So there's an emotional, real emotional aspect to all of this. There is this kind of ambivalency. Now, sevens have a divine umbrella. It's kind of like, you do what you need to do, but somebody's watching out over you. Water is our Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, fluid. It's very emotional energy. So there's this emotional stuff. So it's kind of like, maybe there's an offer for you and you're like, I feel guilty for wanting to do this, or I feel guilty that people are recognizing me. You need to work with that yourself. You need to do what is right. If you're claiming something that belongs to others, then you need to let others be known about that too. But if it's, again, I kind of feel that there's this guilt thing that's hanging over you, and I feel that the Seven of Water, the Seven Divine Energy, is kind of saying, hey, lighten up a little bit. Let's discuss this a little bit. Let's get you on the right path, okay? So the Seven of Water is all about a complex decision, the need to do research, stop procrastinating. So there's some soul searching here, some soul searching, and then hopefully what happens for this weekend is that you're able to move past whatever this is. It does feel like you are, though, again, there is a lot of soul searching to get you there. In a better place, okay? You come out of it in a better place, my Aries. Okay, let's go on and see, because that's six. So we have a 3, 6, and 7. Definitely look those up. Let's see what we have here. And when I say look it up, it is put it in the search browser, put angel numbers behind it, hit enter. Okay. Reversed. The Five of Ariel. Now, it's very interesting that you have all of the energies around you. You have water, air, earth, and fire. And because Ariel in itself is earth. Earth is very tangible. It's something you can feel. Sometimes with your home, your job, your career, your money. Fives has some change energy to it. Positive, negative. Five also has grace to it. It's kind of like I might not deserve it, but I really lucked out. And that's through the angels. That's through the source. That's through the universe. Now, there may be some things, but this does definitely have earthly energy. And I said it was Cancer. I'm sorry. It was Virgo, Taurus, and Capricorn energy. So, but there is definitely an earth component here. Now, this could also be maybe you're going to reach out. Maybe you have family that have gone through some of the same situation. There could be a coming together, so that you can work through some of this. But I also feel like there could be a coming together so you can celebrate some of this too. Okay. And I have no idea where we're going with any of this, but I'm just going to tell you it. Okay. You needn't go through your current challenges alone. Help is nearby. I have been talking about this. Negative thoughts create self-fulfilling prophecies. And you can have negative thoughts between this Three of Air and the Seven of Water. You need to work with your Six of Fire. You need to work with keeping your energies high and your vibrations high. But remember, when we talk about self-fulfilling prophecies, what does that mean? I'm prophesizing over myself. So if you're going to be talking about, if you're going to talk smack about yourself, that's what's going to come back to you. But if you're going to lift those vibrations up and put that out there, that will also come back. Okay? Okay. Now, let's go on. So there is a lot of contemplation right now, a lot of looking at things a little bit differently. That Three of Air is kind of like shrugging off, throwing off, getting to that scratchy place or that itchy place and going, oh, now I now get some relief. There's some relief here. Okay. Let's go on. And we're going to pull one card, the Guardian Angels. And we will see. And, this is part of the poll that I have up on the community page. This is reversed. Six of emotion. So we have that six energy again. Emotion is your cup or water energy. Memories, this makes sense. Memories can fill your heart with many emotions. It's important to remember your past accurately without seeing it as better or worse than what it was. And that might be where the other people come together for you. It's kind of like where they say, oh my gosh, you bet you think that? No, 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 that's not what was real. I've had that happen many times. People you used to know may return to your life unexpectedly. Children could be an important issue, or you may need to reconnect with your own inner child. So, not necessarily saying it's an easy weekend, but it definitely is a necessary weekend. It definitely is that time to really, you know, I kind of get this like, okay, we're going in and we're scrubbing it out. We're scrubbing it out. Okay, let's go on and see what crystal or energy could be helpful for you, my Aries. Yeah, we're looking in all the corners. We're scrubbing. We're cleaning. Cleaning house. Okay, reversed earth energy. You want to go and carry a little bit of earth. And even too, you know, some of the crystals, I mean, think about it. The crystals, they come from the earth. So choose the crystal you would like. Abundance, fertility, harvesting, and logic. It's going to be interesting for you, again, introspection, looking at things. There's some spotlighting to it. There's also some disinfective going towards some of these areas. You do come out of it better. Yeah, we'll see what happens. Let me know, my Aries. I care. Okay. Okay. Remember the button, like, share, subscribe, click on the bell. Most importantly, always know, my Aries, you are loved. Stay shining and be blessed. Bye-bye.